The tool for calculating 3D volumetrics is located under the Geology and Geophysics Perspective, Property Modeling tab, Volumetrics group, and is called Volume. It brings up this window which controls all the volumetrics. Up here at the top, you tell it whether you want to create or edit an existing case. We're going to call this one Volumetrics Case. Over here, we tell it which 3D grid we want to do the volumetrics calculations on. And then there are a bunch of tabs and sub-tabs down here. The Properties main tab has these four sub-tabs, and we'll go through them left to right. In the Models pane, we can look at the 3D grid that we're going to calculate volumetrics on. It has intersections, it has properties. Down here there is a fluid contact set. On this first Properties Fluid Zones area, we tell it whether we want to calculate oil or gas or both. Often, you have to come and uncheck this box over here to the right, even if you tell it that you're using oil, to be able to enter a contact. Over in our 3D grid, highlight, for example, the gas oil contact we want to use. We put it in this location in the middle, highlight the oil water contact we want to use. We put it down here in this bottom area. The top one is for in case there is some other contact above gas. Once the contacts are entered, we can go over here to the General tab. This is where we can enter information for net to gross and porosity. On this first line, any properties we have in our 3D grid with a net to gross template are listed here. We can choose whichever one we want. The next line is porosity. All properties we have with a porosity template are listed here. We can choose whichever one we want. If we decide we want a constant value, we put a check mark in this box that says constant property, and then we can type in whatever we want. However, I'm in this case going to use the property. After we have net to gross and porosity set up, we go to the oil sub-tab here, which controls water saturation. Once again, any water saturation properties we have are listed. We can choose the one we want, or we could choose to put in a constant value. Again, I'm going to use a property. Down in this lower area is where you can put in recovery factors, surface conditions. This is for the oil. There's also a gas tab here. We can click on it and we can put in the same information for gas. So Petrel lets us put in the different properties or constants for gas saturation or for oil saturation, and then it converts it to water saturation for our use later on.